this thing. So in a way you can say that the collapse of Soviet Union began in that rally in 1987, 70 years exactly after the revolution. But again the question is, why so much anger? Why so much anger against the Communist Party? And I being a sympathizer and supporter of the Communist movement, I was wondering and I was asking them, why? What happened really? So one person told me that, look, a friend of mine was looking for an eye and ear specialist. So I said, how can there be eye and ear specialist? There is ear, nose, throat specialist, ENT specialist. There is nothing like eye and ear specialist. So that partner had told this Russian man, no, I want eye and ear specialist because what I see, I do not hear on radio. What I hear on radio is great economic achievements of the Soviet Union, and what I see is pathetic economy. There is so much of corruption, there is so much of shortage, there is so much of famine. That is not reported, that is not what I hear on radio or propaganda machines. So what I hear, I do not see, so obviously the fault is my connection between eyes and ears. And that was, according to most people, the experience of majority of the Soviet people, or at least large number of Soviet people. I began to personally experience the same in a very different way. I went to the famous, world famous Moscow library. It was known as Marx and Lenin library. 8-story building, full of books and magazines, but all first 5 floors only Russian books, that is Russian language books. Counter was good. So I went to the counter, I said, I want English books. He said, English books published in Soviet Union or published abroad? I said, not published in Soviet Union, published abroad. Books published in England, books of America or India for that matter. And I want to also read Indian papers because I have been out of India for the last about 2 months and I have not seen any Indian papers. So if your library gets some Indian papers like India Today magazine or Times of India or Indian Express. He said, but no, you are not allowed to see that. I said, why? He said, for security reasons. We don't allow foreigners to go to the foreign section of the library. So I said, do you allow Russians to go to that foreign section? Yeah, we allow with certain kind of precautions. I said, okay, what precaution I have to take if I have to go there? He said, come tomorrow with some recommendation letter from a professor in the Moscow University that you are a journalist or student or whatever and you are keen to go to the 6th or 7th floor where the English books and English newspapers are there. So I managed to take it from Professor Raza Ali, who was teaching in Moscow University Economics, and I gave the letter and then he accompanied me to that 6th floor. I found some English books written by Russian authors on crisis in Russian economy. They were written by Russians. And then there were, of course, some American books written, British authors have written. All the books were there. Not all, but quite a few books were there. So I was quite impressed. I stayed there for 6 hours and just marked some pages, flagged some pages, and said, okay, last 4 days in Moscow I was going to be there, so I will tear off these pages and photocopy those pages and come to India because it was impossible to take notes of so many things I had seen or marginally read. So I came with the books and a couple of magazines to the counter. I said, can I photocopy these pages? He said, photocopy? That is not allowed. So I said, why? He said, that was security reasons. We don't allow any Xerox. Xerox word was not there because Xerox machine was not there. So we don't allow any photocopying. So I said, then what do I do? What I will do is that if Professor Prasad allows me, I will borrow these books or he will borrow these books from me and I will xerox them outside, photocopy them outside in the shop. He says, outside? No photocopy shops are allowed outside for security reasons. So you can't photocopy anything outside also. So you can't photocopy anything outside, you can't photocopy anything inside. I said, it's okay, 4 days I am here in Moscow. How can I take notes? He said, you can sit here and take notes, but you can't photocopy anything. That was the first experience of how societies are controlled. And though I was a sort of soft comrade or a fellow traveler, brought up in Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's Democratic India, I was not ready for this kind of controls. I told them that I am from India, we have democracy there, and in our country, everybody is entitled to his views, they write articles. They write articles against Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, against his policies, and they are published, they are openly available. And there are so many parties, and everybody criticizes the government policy or supports government policy, and there is a debate. In those days, luckily, there were no these panel discussions to which we are familiar, unfortunately. So, I said, but the debate is free in India, not in parliament, but outside. Public speeches, mochas, we protest against government quite frequently. What we saw the other day in Kremlin, that is nothing for us. Such kind of protests there are every day in streets of Mumbai or Delhi. So, why is this control? Who is going to destabilize your society? The fear, if at all, the fear has to be in countries like India, which are at that time only 40 years old. Why are you afraid? Who are you afraid of? Why are we not allowing libraries to be open? Would Karl Marx agree? Because you have named the library Marx Lenin Library. Would Karl Marx agree to the library being controlled like this? Because Marx had to leave Germany and settle in England and study in London Library because Germany was constraining his intellectual activity. And it was London Library which gave him, all the books, necessary books for his writing thesis. So Marx first believed in freedom, intellectual freedom. And that was the intellectual freedom, the idea of intellectual freedom of Karl Marx, is what impressed me and I became a supporter of the communist ideology. I did not become supporter or fellow traveler of communist ideology of Soviet Union's performance of a socialist state. Therefore, I must say I am quite unhappy with your performance of not allowing people to read and write the way they want. I said, okay, then I am sure you must not be having even cyclostyling machines. I said, no, cyclostyling machine if you possess, it's a crime. Photocopy didn't exist, but cyclostyling machine if you possess, it's a crime. This was the scene of the controlled Soviet Union. Then we visited the shops. Shops were huge like our shopping malls. But most of the shops were virtually empty. Huge windows, huge cupboards, glass cupboards, but very little material inside. There used to be a salesman or saleswoman, but nothing to buy. So finally, I went to a bookshop and again, full of books, majority of the impression of course, but some were English also. So I went to the English section of the books and I saw there a book called Lenin Museum, Illustrated Lenin Museum. Russians, by the way, were excellent in printing technology, absolutely stunningly brilliant printing they had. And so that Illustrated Lenin Museum, or even Moscow Museum, excellent printing, even better than most of the European printing at that point of time. So I saw that book and I said, I want this book. I saw it in the world. So that woman said, no, that is not possible, you can't take it. I said, why? She said, that's only a display copy. I said, I'm not taking that copy, I'm seeing the copy, you get me another copy. She said, another copy does not exist. So I said, is it for security reasons? That Lenin Museum book also is not there. Yesterday Lenin Museum is also not available. For security reasons? She said, no, not available. Generally, the tone of the salesperson was such, which a majority of the Pune customers are familiar with. Completely negative, discouraging. Why are you coming to buy things here? That kind of tone. You should not be buying things. Go home and sleep. In any case, we do that between 12 and 4. So the point is, this was the experience in shop, that was the experience in library. And so I realized that what we were expecting in the chef, or at least Moscow, was not there. So the failure of the model was dawning on us. And that failure of the model, of course, cannot be concluded by a journalist like me or a student of history like me, just by a few personal experiences. Maybe they are odd experiences. They are not necessarily representative experiences. But a representative experience was seen in that march. So I thought what we are witnessing is perhaps the experience of the majority of the people. So I was working in the Economic Times at that time. And so I wrote a big article in the Economic Times. Perestroika and Glasnost, titled Perestroika. The dismantling of the Soviet Union has begun. That is the title published in Economic Times. And the article explained why Soviet Union is likely to be dismantled. This is 1987. Actual Soviet Union was dismantled in 1991 December. So when many of my comrades and friends, even in the union where I worked in Deshpande Employees Union, they said, so finally Kumar, Ketkar has been bought by the capital. He is writing in the capitalist paper called the Economic Times and saying that Soviet Union is going to be dismantled. So this is stark anti-communist, anti-Soviet propaganda. And even a person like Kumar, whom we trusted as a unionist, is actually falling for that propaganda and writing articles against Soviet Union. Perhaps you may not believe. Many friends and comrades virtually stopped talking with me. Like many friends and comrades stopped talking with me after Narendra Modi. Okay. So I'm used to people alienating from me. But the question was, I was brought up in, as I said, Nehru's India, to say what you feel, honestly. And so I said, okay, I may lose friends. If I feel that I was wrong, I will say I was wrong. And I will come clean. That what I said was wrong. If it hurt you, I apologize. But this is what I feel strongly. And this is what I will say. Whether you keep relationship or not is entirely your affair. You are democratically free to choose whether to keep relationship with me. Just so it happened that in 1989, which I described before, when the Berlin Wall came down, apprehensions began among the comrades that things are not working well. Because within a few months after the Berlin Wall failed, the Communist Party of East Germany threw Mr. Erich Honecker out. And a new person was appointed as the Communist Chief in East Germany. I don't know whether you have seen or heard or read a novel by John Le Carre, The Spy Who Came In From the Cold, that gives you proper description of what was East and West Germany, which I mentioned yesterday also. That will give you what was the mood like. But that novel is set in the 60s. And I was talking about Germany in 1980s, late 1980s. So when I wrote this about Germany and later on about Soviet Union, and when I began to get criticized for writing all this, they also began to get apprehensions, because after the Berlin Wall, within a month, Hungarian people started walking towards Germany, free Germany. Now Hungary was also a communist country. Soon there were demonstrations in Albania, in Bulgaria. Czechoslovakia had already started protests. Poland had also started. Poland had already gone over to the non-communist state. and so 1985 elections. So there was a new wind, new wave coming across Eastern Europe about which we are supposed to be. And that wave, which began and was started by Gorbachev after he took over as General Secretary but later President in 1985, soon picked up all over Eastern Europe. And first it was picked up in Eastern Europe, and finally the curtain came down on Soviet Union. Immediately after the German war came down, the German people, representatives of the German people came on stage and announced that soon Germany will be together, Germany will be one. There will be no East Germany and no West Germany. You will not require visa. That we have to say even before actually administrative procedure began to admit that. Can we think of something like that in India-Pakistan one day? Maybe in 2099 or something like that, I don't know. But the Germanies, who were so hostile to each other, that as I said, if you walk from one country to other country, you are shot at the border, they would be detected, treated and deported in those countries. But this began to change the geography of and parties of Eastern Europe. Soon came the Romanian protests against Ceausescu. Hundreds and thousands of people marched on Ceausescu's house, Ceausescu, the president of Romania, and they demanded that he must quit. Initially, again, like Gorbachev, Ceausescu thought that they are coming to celebrate the Romanian revolution. But actually, they began to throw chappals and shoes and bottles at the president, at the Ceausescu's palace. And then Ceausescu realized that they are protesting. So he began to run away. He walked out of the palace and ran away. And when he ran away, some of the leading protesting people also ran after him. So finally he ran away and somehow entered in one farm and killed himself. So his people attackers also found out the farm where he was, located where he was, and a people's court was established, and Ceausescu and his wife were executed right there by the people's court, which was not a communist court. So Romania went. Well, Germany went, then again began to rise. Romania went. As I said, Bulgaria, Albania, Czechoslovakia, 400 already gone. So there was East Europe in turmoil, total turmoil. And at that point of time, I told my comrades who had stopped talking to me, look what is happening. I am not claiming to be clairvoyant. What I was doing was just noting, observing, that if this trend continues, and the protest I had seen in Kremlin, if this protest continues, Eastern European communism will not survive. Or even Soviet Union itself will not survive. And that happened in 1991. But it did not happen all of a sudden. It slowly began to happen. Perhaps you will remember in 1990 that how to bring that country into something like